So disunity has been established in the beginning by God, and it signifies to us the spiritual union between Christ and his church and his people. Mark 10:6-8 says this, "But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh." So they are no longer two, but one flesh. The fact that these words were spoke by Jesus himself shows us that God approves of marriage, and therefore, marriage is a blessing in our lives.
Don't wanna get ahead of myself, feeling things I've never felt. It's kind of hard for me to explain her personality and everything. Brings me to my knees, oh. She shines me up like gold on my arm. I wanna take it slow, but it's so hard. I love to see her face in daylight. It's more than just our bodies at night. But she's really tempting me, oh.
Pedro, will you take Donna to be your wife? Will you commit yourself to lead, sacrifice, and serve her? To love her as God has loved her, and to deny yourself and to honor her. To cherish her and to seek help her grow. Do you promise to do these things both in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, and to be true and loyal to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Then repeat after me. I, Pedro. Promise to support you in our marriage.
Promise to support you in our marriage.
As we seek to grow old together.
As we seek to grow old together.
And through the troubles.
And through the troubles.
That may come.
That may come.
To learn more about each other.
To learn more about each other.
And more about our purpose in life.
And more about our purpose in life.
Before God.
Before God.
Who has made this union possible.
Who has made this union possible.
And our loved ones gathered here today.
And our loved ones gathered here today.
I make this vow to you, Donna.
I make this vow to you today, Donna.
I will love and honor you.
I will love and honor you.
For as long as we both live.
For as long as we both live.
When you rejoice.
When you rejoice.
I will rejoice.
I will rejoice.
And when you hurt.
And when you hurt.
I will hurt.
I will hurt.
It is no longer I.
It is no longer I.
But us.
But us.
God has given us the gift of marriage, and now I receive it.
God has given the gift of marriage, and I receive it.
I, Donna. Promise to support you.
Promise to support you.
In our marriage.
In our marriage.
As we seek to grow old together.
As we seek to grow old together.
And through the troubles.
And through the troubles.
That may come.
That may come.
To learn more about each other.
To learn more about each other.
And more about our purpose in life.
And more about our purpose in life.
Before God.
Before God.
Who made this union possible.
Who made this union possible.
And our loved ones gathered here today.
And our loved ones gathered here today.
I make this vow to you, Pedro.
I make this vow to you, Bubba.
I will love and honor you.
And honor you.
For as long as we both live.
For as long as we both live.
When you rejoice.
When you rejoice.
I will rejoice.
I will rejoice.
And when you hurt.
And when you hurt.
I will hurt.
I will hurt.
It is no longer I.
It is no longer I.
But us.
But us.
God has given us the gift of marriage.
God has given us the gift of marriage.
And now I receive it.
And now I receive it.
You two have made a vow before God, before his elect, and the people gathered here. We're all witnesses to the promises made today by you two, and we all celebrate your union as one. By the privilege that has been given unto me before God and all present here, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Pedro, makes kiss the bride.
Do you think I'm being foolish if I don't rush in? She might be it, that the love is real, that the shoe might fit. She might just be my everything. Beyond space and time in the afterlife, will she have my kids? Will she be my wife? She might just be my everything and beyond. She might just be my
All right, good afternoon, everybody. Xin chào, Phan Sai, La Erwin. You know, looking at everybody's faces, looking at everybody's here, everybody's family, I know everyone's extremely happy for you guys. I know Stephen and Lam are smiling down at Donna, happy that she, you know, seeing her sister married. And basically, the only thing that I want to tell you guys is that there's no such thing as a perfect marriage, but there are people that are perfect for each other. Donna, you're perfect for Pedro. Pedro, you're perfect for Donna. So I want you guys to take each other with your imperfections and your imperfections. May God bless you. May God bless your marriage. I love you guys, and I hope you guys have a happily ever after.
I got my peaches out in Georgia. Yeah, shit. I get my weed from California. That's that shit. I took my chick up to the north, yeah. Badass bitch. I get my light right from the source, yeah. Yeah, that's it. And I see you.
Now, put your hands on the floor, make some noise, go crazy for the new Mr. and Mrs. Oliver!
Souvenirs. There's no time, I wanna make more time and give you my whole life. I left my girl, I'm in my Yorker. Hate to leave a college torture. Remember when I couldn't hold her. Left her baggage for a mover.
My dearest Donna, my forever baby sister, I am so proud of the young woman you have grown up to be. I'll never forget the first time I met you. You had two French braid ponytails and a total brace face. You sat down next to me in the backyard, not really saying anything but just smiling. And I'm so happy to see that beautiful smile on your big day today as you married the love of your life. You've been through so much, baby girl, and it really takes time to heal. But lean on Pedro to help you on this journey. Trust him as the head of your household and respect the future decisions he will make. As backwards as it may sound, for my independent, strong-willed, traveling sister, this will actually make you even stronger, honorable, and you'll climb even further in your career as you expand the family. Pedro, thanks for loving and taking care of one of the greatest treasures I have. I've already seen firsthand what a great leader and support you are to her. I look forward to spending more time with you and building a stronger sibling relationship. Now to both of you. Never go to bed upset at each other, but have an open heart and ear for one another. Keep open lines of communication and have patience for each other. Take to heart that both of you are no longer two, but truly one. I love both of you so much, and I will be praying that God bless you guys abundantly on this new journey of married life.
Georgia, oh yeah, shit. I get my weed from California, that's that shit. I took my chick up to the north, yeah, badass bitch. I get my light right from the source, yeah, yeah, that's it. I got my peaches out in Georgia, oh yeah, shit. I get my weed from California, that's that shit. I took my chick up to the north, yeah, badass bitch. I get my light right from the source, yeah, yeah. I got my peaches out in Georgia, oh yeah, shit. I get my weed from California, that's that shit. I took my chick up to the north, yeah, badass bitch. I get my light right from the source, yeah. Yeah, that's it. I got my peaches out in Georgia. Oh yeah, shit. I get my weed from California. That's that shit. I took my chick up to the north, yeah. Badass.